The Paris-based International Astronomical Union has just officially named an asteroid as 7431 Jettaguilar in honor of Filipino Dr. Jose Francisco Jettaguilar, a neurosurgeon at the Philippine Children's Medical Center and Philippine General Hospital, who is also an amateur astronomer. Here to tell us more about the story behind this is the doctor astronomer himself, Dr. Jettaguilar. Good morning, Dr. Aguilar. Thank you for joining us.
Hi, good morning, Ms. Nikki. Thank you for having me.
So first off, tell us the story behind this discovery of the asteroid back in 1993, I think, from sighting to now, and being named after you, as well as could you describe for us the asteroid itself? Where does it orbit around? How big? All those other information.
Well, thank you. Actually, it was just announced December last year that this particular asteroid got my name, and it was really a total surprise. It was discovered.
What a Christmas surprise!
It was discovered actually way back in 1993 at the European Southern Observatory in Chile, and the official designation there was asteroid 1993 FN41, and it is the International Astronomical Union which actually names these asteroids after personalities or persons or scientists, Nobelists, whatever. No, and the ones who proposed my name, Ms. Imelda Holson and Mr. Edwin Aguirre, are science astronomy writers based in the United States. And they saw my work for our work at the Astronomical League of the Philippines advocating astronomy to the Filipino public, and also my work as a neurosurgeon at the Philippine Children's Medical Center. So they proposed my name, I think, in 2020. But it was also a complete surprise. And I would actually think that this is an acknowledgement of the Filipino healthcare workers who are now working in the pandemic, delivering health services despite the dangers and all the hardships. Thank you.
Agreed. And as a longtime astronomer, have you ever dreamed of one day discovering or being a name pala after a heavenly body?
Well, not in my wildest dreams, is what I told them before. But we had some prominent Filipinos who had asteroids named after them. Aside from Etwelda, there's a Father Victor Badillo, Dr. Roman Quintanar of the Pag-asa, and lately is Christopher Goh. He's a famous internationally famous planetary imager in Cebu, who had a lot of discoveries to his name.
And despite your busy medical practice, you've been an ardent astrophotographer, right, for more than 15 years, and you've even traveled overseas to observe and photograph total and annular solar eclipses in various countries. When did this love for astronomy start?
Well, I believe like most of us, we have a childhood fascination with the sky or with astronomy. Mm-hmm. And when I finally had the time after I was already a practicing neurosurgeon, I decided to take up the hobby in 2003, more for my children so that I will kindle in them the interest in science and for the young people, because astronomy makes us appreciate more actually the Earth, no? The beauty of the Earth, and appreciate the environment. I'll just like to plug in that actually the third week of February has been, there's a presidential proclamation that the third week of February is National Astronomy Week. So, the Filipino people should appreciate astronomy and eventually the Earth and the environment. And hopefully it will encourage us to preserve the environment.
And Dr. Aguilar, you know, as we've been talking about, you're a Filipino neurosurgeon who has saved over 1,000 children in the Philippines, treating their congenital malformations and brain tumors. But you are also an amateur astronomer and vice president of the Astronomical League of the Philippines. So how do you compartmentalize you being a medical doctor and you being an amateur astronomer?
Well, actually, it's the sky is actually there 24/7 for you to view. And usually we schedule it on times that we are free, our group, when we do our stargazing. And it's actually not a conflict. It's not a problem. No, it's very easy. Astronomy is a very easy hobby.
So since you've already said, no, it's a hobby. It's more of a hobby for you than something academic, ba?
Yeah. So I'm not actually a professional or an academic astronomer.
And
I'm
now
just an
you
amateur.
But yeah. Still, to have an asteroid named after you, that is no mere feat.
Yeah, that's why it came as a complete surprise.
Mm-hmm. And now you join a growing list of Filipino astronomers and scientists who have asteroids named in their honor. Kanina, diba, you mentioned a few. And as an astrophotographer, what else do you want to see among the Filipino community in astronomy?
Actually, it's a good way of getting appreciating the beauty of the heavens and sharing it with the other people, and it's not difficult, like I said, and you don't have to buy expensive equipment or expensive telescopes. You can actually just use your cell phone, binoculars, and so on. Like I said, the sky is free. And anyone, I see a lot of young people who are getting interested rather than concentrating on sitting in their computer all day. They can look at the sky, especially in this age of the pandemic. You don't actually need it's very easy during the pandemic with all the lockdowns to just go out in the sky and look up.
Agreed. It could be very therapeutic. No? All right. Thank you so much for joining us this morning for a very interesting topic, Dr.
Thank you, everyone. Yeah. Thank you so much, and stay safe. Thank you. Bye-bye.